Salman Khan. Our chief guest for the evening, please have your seat. It's an honor to have you with us. And I'd like to now invite on stage two very crucial people without whom this evening was not going to be possible. That is the subject of a lovely autobiography called Asha Parikh, The Hit Girl. So just guess who the first person is. Yes, it is our lovely lady, the golden lady, the hit girl, not only of the 60s and the 70s, but also of today. Asha ji, please, and Khalid Mohammed, where are you? Where are you, Khalid? May we please have you up on stage?
At the Taj Lands End for the last two decades, we have been associated with the film industry. And what pleasure then today when we can host this book by Asha Parikh ji and Ajay, when he came to us and said that he wants to bring this book to this hotel, it was a complete delight for us. I won't take too much time. I would leave all the ceremonies to Salman and Asha Parikh ji, and thank you for being here. Thanks.
To beat her role of the runway girl in Karwa, box office, Asha ji, for all the hits and the hit girl, Salman Khan, thank you for your very warm tribute to Asha ji in the book and for being here today. Taj Lands End is my home away from home, and I thank Mr. Parveen Chander and his wonderful team for being such fine hosts. And last but not least, Khalid Mohammed. I can never thank you enough for suggesting to Asha ji that she tell her story, and then for calling me up to ask me whether I would like to publish The Hit Girl. Could I have said anything but a resounding yes? And the book has turned out to be lovely indeed. Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, have a lovely evening. Thank you.
Thank you very much. That was Ajay Mago, publisher Om Books International and the publisher of this book called Asha Parikh, The Hit Girl. And the next person, actually, I fumble when every time I introduce him. This is the third book that we're doing together. And I'm talking about none other than Khalid Mohammed.
Perfection is not a good thing, or so it's said. But today, I will have to show some of my emotion, especially in thanking Helen G and Salim Saab, who was here earlier. He said he was going for a walk and may come back. So they've sort of seen me when I was, let's say, in my 20s, and I've had the most glorious evenings with them. Salim Saab is a great storyteller, and I wish I could still spend evenings with him, listening to his wonderful stories. Then my other display of affection is, of course, for Wahida ji, whom I've revered ever since I was, a teenager, seeing her movies, interviewing her once in a while, and she's grace personified, what do I say? Then there is Dharam ji, Dharmendra Saab, who also gave me one of my earliest interviews, and he spoke frankly, and it was a cracker of an interview. So welcome, Dharmendra Saab, and thank you indeed. Apart from that, my gratitude goes out to my only boss, actually, Mr. Pradeep Guha, whom I consider a boss. He's helped me through, you know, taking up any subject, any film, and he's my agony uncle, and sometimes I hope to be his, not yet. And my last word of gratitude is for a little boy who I saw, who was very tough, very good looking, and who was destined for stardom. He went through his ups and downs, and I'm sure all of us agree, no, he's still not going through ups and downs. I'm sure all of us agree that if it's a Salman Khan movie, it's our first day, first show movie.
With Khalid. And Khalid, you were very modest. You didn't say anything about making a writer out of Salman Khan. Thank you for that. Aren't you happy, Salman Khan, about it?
No, I convinced him to write and do the foreword. I was just a backseat boy, and it's Ashaji's book, totally. And thank you, Ashaji, for getting Salman and Salim Saab and Helen G and all of us here today. Thank you.
Well, I stand corrected. Whoever it was one of you, and we're happy that Salman Khan has started writing. So we're going to be commissioning you for your full-fledged book at the end of the event. Now, the star of the evening. The hit girl, the golden girl, the silver girl. Her movies ran for 50 weeks, 25 weeks minimum. There were directors who would queue up for her, and they knew that if she was in a film, they didn't have to worry about the box office ringing, and ringing loud and clear. But this was a lady who was once.
Dear friends, I am overwhelmed. I thought that since I have not exactly kept a high profile or sparked headlines, very few people would be interested in knowing what I have to say today. Your presence and the smiles I see in the hall today mean a lot to me. It's almost as if my decades-long journey, professional and personal, have made a connect with all of you. What I have to say, then, are a few essentials. One, my autobiography. I agreed to, after much procrastination, should I not? Then I convinced myself that I have nothing to be wary about as long as I don't touch my words in obscurity, but say it in the way it was working in our fabulous film industry from the black and white days, which breezed majorly towards color in the 1960s. From a child artist to a leading lady, the transition was not exactly easy. It's luck and the faith instilled in me by my directors and the film industry at large, which seemed to be in my favor. I was blessed by the Lord and the encouragement of my parents. Secondly, in the course of constructing the book, there was the recurring questions from my friends, family, and the fans who have preserved their interest in me. The question was, is there enough masala in the book, or is it a tell-all, or is it, well, evasive? To that, my honest answer is that I have attempted to be absolutely honest, sincere. My words are neither cloaked in vagueness nor sensationalism. Truth, it's the big word, I know. But truth is what you will find in the book. Third point, I would not be alive and standing here before you without the unflagging support of my friends Wahida Rahman, Saira Banu, Helen Khan, Shami Aunty, and the Khan family. Thank you for being there. Thank you for being there for me always through thick and thin. And my heart cannot express enough gratitude to Salman Khan, whom I've seen ever since he was in a cradle and then as a lively child, and now, of course, as a superstar and a man dedicated to being human. Salman, thank you for penning the foreword for your Auntie Asha and for being here today to launch the book. Ladies and gentlemen, join me in thanking Salman personally. Next, my wholehearted shukriyas go to Khalid Mohammed, whom I have known since he was a journalist who had not even sprouted a mustache. Right from the start, I could see his integrity and a gift for thoughtful writing. As the writer of the book, I trusted him implicitly, and he fulfilled the trust to the last comma and full stop. Thank you, Dilse, to Ajay Mago of Om Books International. A happy, enthusiastic, and sensitive publisher. Believe me, he has a peppy personality which can be as entertaining as a full, fun-filled movie. And thanks, Deepa Chaudhary, the editor for the book, always composed during the months it took to see the book towards completion. I am grateful to my esteemed well-wishers who made this evening a reality. Mr. Chetan Shah, Mr. Paresh Vora, Mr. Viral Chitalia, Mr. Manu Chatlani, and Abu Jani and Sandeep Khosla. Without much more ado, then I would like to conclude, ladies and gentlemen, book leke dekho, and dare I say, enjoy. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
You leave all of us speechless even today. What to do? That's the effect that she has on all of us. So after that is the turn.